Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy! Welcome back to more Xenoblade Chronicles! Last time, Shulk rejoined the fray as we fought off the Telethia from Colony 6, and we learned that due to a hole in the Bionis chest made from Egil's final attack, we have a way to reach Zanza. Egil will be helpful to our cause, even in death. This time, rather than go onward and try to face Zanza now, if our last encounter with him is any indication, we are nowhere near strong enough to take on a god, so I say we make ourselves a lot stronger and equip ourselves a lot better, and what a way to do that than talk to these merchants right here that are on the back of junks. They were not here before. Well, rather, they were here before, but, you know, we actually have party members now that can equip this stuff. First off are two slot weapons for the entire party other than Shulk. These are not anti-mechon weapons. However, now that the Mechonus is destroyed, there are very few mechon left in the entire world. So if you are worried about not having anti-mechon properties to your weapon, do not worry about that any longer. You might as well buy more powerful equipment for your party now instead. As such, I'm gonna do this for Ricky, Dunban, and I guess that's it. The first merchant also has a bunch of art books for Fiora. I'm not gonna really complain much though, because a lot of these arts are pretty good and I would want to level them up even further, but why would a Homs merchant have books that further the ability of a mechon? Maybe he was stockpiling them and hiding them? I don't know. The other merchant has the Brave series of light equipment with one slot on it, but we've been able to obtain these for some time now. As you can see, I personally own 7 of these without even talking to this guy in the first place. He also has heavy armor consisting of Retrieved and Gemini sets. These aren't really, well, okay, I guess I shouldn't say they're not that great. If you personally are going out for heavy armor, I guess they could be good for Ryan. But I think I'm gonna switch Ryan back off of heavy armor in the near future, so I don't think I'll be getting any of these. What you really want to see are these unique pieces of equipment for Fiora. If you choose to go with the Aether 3 series, she gets debuff resist 4, which gives her a 30% chance of resisting any and all debuffs. Attack plus 5, which I've already told you I'm not a fan of. Aether up 5, which is what you would expect. And of course, another Aether up 5. Very helpful. Speed 3 will give you aggro down 5. I think I really, really want that. Speed 3 series gives aggro down 5, which reduces aggro generated by all arts by 20%. Yeah, I think I want that. Haste 5, which I've already spoken very highly of in the past. Agility up 5, which, as I've said before, agility is a huge deal. And another agility up 5. Attack 3 series gives you Arts Heal 5. That recovers 50 HP every time an art connects with an enemy. Because her Talon Art Sword Drones is a 10-hit combo, that is 500 HP recovered every time you use it. Combine that with Speed Shift giving her Talon Arts often, yeah, that is a very good gem for Fiora. Attack Stability 5, which raises the minimum damage of your attacks. I've said that I think more highly of this personally than Attack Plus. Strength up 5. And of course, as always, another strength up 5. The Power 3 series, of course, as per usual, is her heavy armor. This gives you aggro up 5, allowing her to tank easily. Damage heal 5, which I'm not that big of a fan of. It makes it so that you have a 25% chance of recovering 100 HP every time you take damage. It's just kind of out there. I just don't really feel too right about it compared to Arts Heal or even Aura Heal. Good Footing 5 makes it so that she resists blowdown 50% of the time. And Topple Resist 5, you know what it does. As for the drones, the Eris drones give her Gun Drones 2, which we have already seen. The Lucina drones will class change her into a Lord. Okay, no, not really. They give her Cannon Drones 2, which we have not seen already, and they have an empty slot. And then the Uranus drones give Sword Drones 2, which, as you can tell, highly intrigues me. There is a reason why this is the most expensive one. You bet I want that. As for the art books, I'm not really a fan of this guy's selection. We don't need the Summon Bolt art book because we got a level 10 book of that for free by going into the treasury in the Hyantia Tomb. I don't personally use Summon Flare or Summon Aqua. You might, but I personally don't. Final Flicker, I don't use either. Summon Ice, I decided to buy just cuz, but this is the one that really gets to me and is a slap in the face. Peekaboo. The bonus effect of that was inflicts Confuse against Mechon. I've already stated that there are so few Mechon from here on out that it's just not useful. Same goes for the other guy. He had Magstorm. That's why I suggested that you equip Magstorm for the bonus effect, but you don't level it up, because there's just so few Mechon from here on out that why would you? Other than that, Power Effect, I've already explained my issue with that, and Drive Boost, it's okay, I guess. Who would have guessed that the next step is to, use the art books that I just obtained? Yeah, I'm not gonna save the art leveling up for the end slate just because there's not a whole lot that I want to do, so it'd be kind of weird just to, like, not talk about it. First off, of course, if I just used an art book for it, I'm probably gonna level it up as far as I can go, especially in the case of Summon Ice. I like the damage over time. It is very nice. Mind Blast, of course, I want to level that up. It is fantastic getting that extra time of art seal out of that. For Ricky, I want to level up Bitey Bitey. I think I'm going to go all the way to level 10 on this, actually, just because I do use it a lot. And again, I am a fan of damage over time. Plus, it does give me something else to heal off with Say Sorry, so of course I want to do that. Yeah, you know what? I will go all the way to level 10 with that. Alright, we are all maxed out. I think I'm going to go for Ricky is Angry. I'm going to level this up a little bit. It's just that I've been mainly using Hero Time lately, but I think I want to switch over to Ricky is Angry because I mainly use Ricky for tanking as of late. As for Dunban, it hurts me. I have so much AP on him, and I have nothing to spend it on without getting more art books. As for Charla, of course, my favorite art with her is Headshot, so I'm gonna go for that as well. Ryan, you hurt me as well. I have nothing to spend your AP on either. Fiora, on the other hand, comes through for me. I just used an art book on Cross Impact, and I want to level it up quite a bit. Like I said, Magstorm just isn't really helpful to me anymore, so I'm gonna put that on. Now that we have an attack the forces topple, having a quick daze attack like this is definitely good. And lastly, Monado Shield. You're gonna start running into enemies that have level 8 talent arts. As such, I recommend you level up your shield to level 8. Here's how everyone's looking in the way of equipment. Shulk isn't really all that different, just decided to give him a quick step gem and change a few pieces of armor. Melianel looks positively ridiculous, with the exception of the Imperial Staff. Just decided to give that to her because it was better than the anti-mechon weapons we've been using. Ricky, I decided to give an aggro up gem because I use him for tanking a lot as of late, and I can just totally picture him being like, "Oh, you trick Ricky into holding big shiny that attract monster attention, Ricky mad!" Just, you know, because he's kind of a coward at times. It's just kind of cute, and speaking of cute, he still looks so adorable that I just want to give him a great big hug. Dunban, now that we have more freedom in what weapons we can equip, I gave him back double attack gems, which I was doing a lot early game, but I haven't really been doing lately, just because a lot of the really good Machina weapons were unique. So, that's kind of my explanation for that. Charla's not really looking all that different either, just kind of made her a bit defensive in the gems that I gave her, but, you know, just gave her the weapon that does the most damage, simple as that. Not really a whole lot there. Ryan, I wasn't really sure what to do with. I just didn't really have enough supplies to go around for him, which is why he looks kind of hodgepodge the way that I have him right now. He is still outfitted for tanking, but he is still outfitted for offense as well, so I kind of just went with a best of both worlds approach for him. I hope it'll work. I gave him more offensive arts as opposed to defensive arts as well, kind of switching him back to what I had before we fought Gatto. But yeah, that's kind of what he's looking like. Fiora, I've changed a little bit. She still has her double attacks and haste, which I've already explained why I like those. I gave her aggro down 5 because I've been just praying for an aggro down gem and now I have one. So definitely went for that. She has strength up now because with Magstorm no longer being useful, that gives her zero gravity and final cross, and unless you give her an ether talent art, she doesn't have any other ether arts to really use, so I'm just not going to be using ether with her anymore. How many times did I just say ether? Go. Time's up. Okay. Also, apologies to Fire Emblem fans, but I won't be using the Lucina drones for long. I just want to show what the talent art on them does. I will be going to Sword Drones 2 in the very near future as my main talent art on her. That is all I wanted to do in the way of equipping ourselves for the road ahead, so I think we are good to move on to what the bulk of this video will be. Letting you know, there's not going to be any story progress in this video because a lot of things have changed around— what the— what is Ricky doing? And now he's just dancing in celebration of his inhumanly fast running and swimming abilities. Or in Noponly in his case. Anyway, I was saying that Junks is now in Colony 6. It will be here unless you go to the Fallen Arm, in which case it goes with you. Presumably, that is how you were able to skip travel between this and the Fallen Arm. Does not explain how you were able to do it back when you didn't know it could fly, but I digress. The Homs and Machina in Colony 6 now coexist peacefully. If there was ever a time for it to happen, it would be this. It's an example of, you know, how the worst of times can bring out the best in people. And speaking of bringing out the best in Colony 6, I say we get to reconstructing it. This is how we're going to be spending the rest of our video, is reconstructing Colony 6, doing some various things around town. We have 42% completion, and considering how far we've made it, that's not all that great. We have the ability to get some new materials to help reconstruct the colony. I decided to do a lot of this off-screen. I already have all the materials necessary for as much as I want to reconstruct it. Of course, at the bottom of the screen, you can indeed see the materials. When raising up housing up to level 3, was it 4? Level 4, sorry, bleh. Wow, I can't believe I just forgot. You will, of course, build more houses, you know, you'll get these nice little knock-on huts over by Junks, you know, really diversifies things a lot, but this will extend the main street of Colony 6 from the Reconstruction HQ all the way to the main entrance. So, things are looking a lot more complete now, just in general, because there's a lot less rubble. Getting housing to level 5 is a little bit interesting. As you can see, I only have a few of these materials, and one of the ones that I need is a Gogol Horn. This actually brings me into something that people have been asking about for a very, 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 very long time. I want you to think way, way back, like 7 months back when the series was only just beginning. Yeah, hard to believe that there was ever a time like that now. Remember those really tough high-level enemies that were in like the earliest areas of this game? Well, a lot of you were just kind of going like, you know, that is kind of funny that you're having trouble like with level 75 enemies killing you in like the first area. But what's the point? Like, you know, they're just being jerks, aren't they? Well, believe it or not, these enemies did serve a purpose. These goggles that you're seeing right here on Bionis Leg, they drop materials necessary for Colony 6. They also were standing in front of an area on Bionis Leg that we never got to go to before because they were in front of it. So, not only do we get to explore a new area that we've never been to before, we have a reason to come back to some earlier areas, and in the process, we get ourselves some nice materials for Colony 6 as well. It's really nice that they give you a reason to come back like this, and they really emphasize the exploration this much. Would I completely defend this feature saying that they weren't just trying to be jerks to beginners when they were starting off? Nah, they probably were. Now, I have not mentioned that these are level 75 monsters compared to my level 71, yet I'm doing decently enough against them, I guess. If you're having trouble getting chain attacks going against them, I would suggest bringing in characters with high agility. I have Shulk outfitted with agility gems, and Dunban, of course, has amazing agility all the same. This is important, of course, because if your agility is drastically lower than the enemy's, your physical attacks are going to be forced into missing a lot. And quite frankly, how do you expect to win a fight if you aren't attacking? Alternatively, you could try using Melia, as she has ether attacks, and this actually brings me into something. Melia's Spear Break is an example of an art with really good knockback. These enemies are close to a cliff. It is indeed possible to use knockback to knock enemies that are really high level off of cliffs in this area, and if you can actually do that, you will get all the experiences if you killed them. This is a fantastic level up tactic, and it's just kind of one way that you can get lots of experience really easily, but even though I personally find it a little bit cheap, if side quests aren't your thing and you just want to get a couple of easy levels to help you beat a boss that you're just having trouble with, there's no shame in it. With all of these tips, if you still are just unable to get a material from a really high-level monster because you just cannot beat it in battle, you can always just fill up Ricky's talent gauge by auto-attacking weak enemies, get into a battle with these guys, and then just use his yoink and once he steals an item, run away from the battle. It is a valid tactic for getting items that you need when you just can't beat the monster otherwise. And by doing that, we actually now have all the materials for housing level 5. This is the highest level that you can possibly reach on any of these. Personally, I think it would have been kind of classy if there was a level 6 to everything, you know, seeing it as it is Colony 6 and all. But I guess you can't have all the classiness all in one place all the time. So it'll just have to do. We get Reconstruction plus 3, Population plus 27 for that. And for completing housing all the way up to level 5, we get a special bonus. Our reward for that is Oriental Glasses. What, they make your eyes look Asian? Okay, I'm sorry. I couldn't resist. That was just... What else can I think of when I see Oriental Glasses? And don't take that as me insulting or anything, it's just me being stupid. Frankly, I think Asian eyes are beautiful. I also want to up Commerce to level 4. For doing that, we will get some more shops built along Main Street, of course. What else did you think was going to happen? That is what commerce does, after all. And you might have just heard that the music changed. Yes, we got the achievement Affix on the Solution, and our completion of Colony 6 has exceeded 50%. Coming along quite nicely, I must say. First new shop is run by a Hyantia right here. Very cool looking Hyantia, I must say. Then again, they're all cool looking. Let's see just what she's got here. As per usual, all these weapons suck. They're not nearly as good as what we could have had for a long time now. The only stat being risen by any of this armor in the entire party would be this heavy gear raising Ryan's physical defense. Jailtop, we ain't in Valak Mountain anymore, and we could not have reconstructed it this far in Valak Mountain. Are you for real? Yes, you can bet, as per usual, the commerce upgrades in Colony 6 really don't give you anything you could have already had for ages at this point. These art books, man, I have already learned every one of these that I care about. Meaning that I could have gotten them from other sources, and did. That is all there is in the way of shopping after Commerce Level 4, yeah, great, isn't it? I could technically raise Commerce up to Level 5 at this point, but that is a lot of money compared to how much I have, and I'm just kind of afraid of not having enough money for everything else, so I'd rather do the other things I plan on doing first. Nature Level 2 is one such thing. I can easily afford this, I have way more than enough materials, except for the ice cabbages, those suck. Let's just raise Nature up to Level 3 and see what it gets us. Nature increased by 1! Flowers have been planted on Main Street! The Mine's Ether Crystals have gone up in rank! We got Reconstruction plus 2, and apparently those flowers weren't very good because nobody came to live here because we planted them. Well, them's the breaks. Can't win them all. And it seems we've gotten something else for our troubles now as well, because it's panning over the colony. Completion bonus, level 3, streetlights have been built. So because everything is at least level 3, we not only got streetlights built around the colony, which will light it up at night, but we also get, more importantly, topple plus 4. I believe that is, extends the duration for which an enemy suffers from topple. Can definitely be a useful gem if you so much want to topple lock enemies. Next up is Nature level 4. We will do that as well. Trees! Trees everywhere! They are made of very flat-looking textures when they are viewed that up close. Yeah, I'll admit the trees look a lot better when viewed from far away. A well-built tree-lined street. We built a tree-lined street. And the Mine's Aether Crystals have gone up in rank once again, so we can now get some pretty darn Aether Crystals here at the colony. And enemies are attacking the colony's Aether Platters. Maybe they've attracted the Aether there. Fend off the attack before one of the inhabitants gets hurt! We have Defend Colony 6 Elite. We need to defeat the M71 Fire Support near the planter at the freight elevator. Nobody messes with my Aether Crystals and gets away with it. I shall deal with the immediate threat to the Aether Crystals! Oh, and to the colony as well. Yeah, they said something about residents, something like that. I'll deal with that as well. Upon getting over here, you will notice there are Telethia about. They are only like level 60 and I don't really get what the point is. You need to have finished Makana's core for them to appear here, and they are far too weak to be of any threat to you or to even pay any attention to you. Maybe they're just kind of slow Telethia that didn't realize that Dixon and the others had just kind of flown off already, but hey, they're here if you really want to fight them. More importantly though, this is the M71 Fire Support. I don't really get why it's a Mechon attacking, considering that this is pretty close to the soonest possible opportunity you would have to deal with this thing. And the Mechon are kind of gone from the world now for the most part. I guess it's just, well, we need a big bad something or other that'll attack the colony and have it be spoiler free. Let's just have it be a Mechon, even though that won't make any sense after a certain point. So I guess that's the reasoning behind it. Let's, oh right, we don't have anti-Mechon weapons, do we? Fiora can just hurt them normally, and Melia is able to do at least decent damage against them. I'm just gonna topple it, and we will go for the Mind Blast. This should easily finish it off, or not quite, actually. Wow, who knew this thing could be so formidable? And as soon as I say that, it goes down. Well, we got 12,000 gold, 8,000 experience taking that out. The attack is now over, so everything should be back to normal. Now, I put that now in the middle of the sentence and realized my mistake halfway through. Get that, we get more affinity with Colony 6, and that... Wait a minute, chest? I didn't think this thing dropped a chest. Okay, I'll take your cylinders, sure. Back in the colony, we cannot level up special to level 4 because it requires items from places we have yet to go to. Same goes for nature level 5, so we are done with those. Housing we have maxed out, and we ended up having enough money after all to do commerce level 5, so I say we do that. There is a single item needed for commerce level 5 that I want to make special mention of outside of just what you see in the bottom bar. That is the Ocean Elixir of Life. That is dropped by Alexos, found during rain, right where we fought that Mechon just now, so you should know exactly where that is. The Ocean Elixir of Life, you will need one more other than the one needed for Commerce, so I recommend you grab two of them right now. But for that, we complete Commerce all the way up to level 5, and our special reward for that? Titan Arms! Oh! Titan Arms are a unique piece of heavy armor. As you can see, the amount of physical defense you get is insane. Ryan has 637 with what he's got now, that would raise him up to 717. Pierce Resist 5 makes it so that you have a 50% chance of resisting pierce status, which basically makes it so that your defense is ignored when you are attacked. Can be really useful if you're fighting an enemy that has that status. We're not going to be fighting any in the immediate future, but definitely keep it in mind. That is all the reconstruction I wanted to do. Nay, it is actually all the reconstruction we are able to do. Feels so accomplishing to say that. That puts us at 60% completion in Colony 6. It'd be better if it was 66%, because then we're just really going all out with the 6, but oh well. Okay, that was a lot of reconstruction to go over. I appreciate you being patient with me. I can understand that was a lot to go over all at one time. But this is just kind of one of those moments where the story brings us back to Colony 6, and there's a lot more we can do now than we could before, and the rewards were very worthwhile. We got some really good stuff for that. But speaking of rewards, I did just level Commerce up to level 5. And I bet you think you know what I'm gonna say, don't you? Believe it or not, Commerce level 5 doesn't suck. I know, had to happen sooner or later, might as well be the final upgrade. These weapons really aren't bad. They are 2-slot variants on some really not bad pieces of equipment. I am actually kind of a fan. Problem though, look at how expensive these items are. This is why I chose to buy items from those merchants at the start of the video, and I didn't just wait for this store to be open. I'd have to spend so much money to get the store open in the first place because it has to be Commerce level 5 for you to get it. And even if I just went straight for that, I probably would not have enough money to upgrade the party, so I'm cool with having less good equipment for right now, and just going over all this later. There are two other stores that open up at Commerce level 5, and I will also go over those at a later point when I want to upgrade the party, but there is a particularly good thing that I want to show off. We have the art book for Final Cross right here. You can just go get a level 10 art book if you can kill some certain unique monsters at this point, but you know what? I'm okay with spending 24,000 gold to be able to level up Final Cross because it is just that darn good. As you can guess, because Fiora has 46,684 unspent AP, yes, I had to name that number exactly, I'm going to upgrade this as far as I can. We now have a level 7 Final Cross. I gotta say, that's pretty crossome. I am so lame. With all that done, that is almost everything I want to do in Colony 6 for the time being. We're not going to do any more reconstruction, no more equipment, no more leveling up arts or anything like that. That's not to say that we are all done with preparations, though. We are still only level 72, and we can stand to be much higher than that, though, so I think we will be doing some side questing in the very near future. But for now, I think I just want to switch to daytime so we can appreciate the gorgeous vista outside of Colony 6. And on that note, there is indeed a heart-to-heart that we are now able to view. Recovery and reflection. If you've been watching carefully, you hawk-eyed viewers, you would notice that I switched into a member of the party. Indeed, it is Dunban with Fiora. It's horrible to think of what the Mechon did to Colony 6. Yes, the devastation here was far worse than in Colony 9. There were two things we had that they didn't, Shulk and the Monado. Yes, not that their defense force was anything to sneeze at, but in the end, the Mechon just overwhelmed them. Makes me sad. So many lives lost, and Sharla lost someone so close to her. Many lives were sacrificed, more than could ever be justified. Even now that I know the reasons behind the Mechon's actions. Everyone here just wanted to protect the people they loved. They didn't deserve this. To protect those we love, we often must sacrifice everything. Must have been really tough. The Colony 9 attack is so vivid in my mind. I can hear Shulk scream as the metal-faced Mechon attacked me. Shulk was a wreck after that. I'd never seen the boy so distraught. I imagine that's how the people of Colony 6 felt. I made up my mind after that. I decided I'd never endanger myself so thoughtlessly again. I should hope so too, Fiora. I won't forget his cries, and I don't wish to hear them again. I'll be more careful in the future. That's my promise to you, Dunban. I won't throw my life away. I'll hold you to that promise. We'd all miss you too much if you were gone. Me, Shulk, Ryan. I know, it was a silly thing to do. No matter how tough the battle is, how scary it gets, we all need to stick together. Yes, that's the only way. Okay, I think it's time we were getting back to the others. They might be getting worried. After what happened, I bet Shulk is afraid to let me out of his sight. Come on, Dunban, hurry it up. I promise you, Fiora, I'll never let you come to such harm again. It's so sweet just to see these moments that take place in these beautiful scenic vistas. Then again, whenever you have a vista like this, how can you help but not have a touching moment? It's just kind of the rules of, cinematography, I guess. Okay, no, not really. With that done, we have gotten some really nice rewards. We have made the colony look a lot like its old self that we never actually saw, but I'm sure Sharla and Atharon can attest to it looking a lot like its old self again. And with the things I've said about Sharla in the past, I'm certain that she would agree with me. Yeah. But anyway, next time on Xenoblade Chronicles, we're going to be going around the Bionis and seeing just how much things have changed. The body of the Bionis has shifted in the fight with Egil, so because of that, things have, well, changed a lot. We'll just say that much. See you guys then.